Let's go to Genesis chapter number 4 this morning as we have our daily devotion. And we'll see the first death. Remember again, sin brings death. And God had warned Adam and Eve. And now they're going to see not only has an animal died, but they're going to see one of their children die. What a sad thing that is for a parent to have to see that their own actions brought about the death of their children. And they're going to see it very clearly in the death of Abel. In Genesis chapter 4, verses 1 through 7, it says, "Now Adam knew Eve, his wife, that is, they had sexual relationship, and she conceived and bore Cain, and said, I have acquired a man from the Lord." Then the naming of her, many of the commentators say that she believed he was the one who was to come, the seed of the woman. And that would be natural. I mean, that would be a very good understanding that now I've had a child who will crush the head of the serpent. And so she thought this was going to be the one. Boy, was she wrong. And she began to watch that child grow up and see his sin nature, that the heart is desperately wicked. It's evil. Who can know it? And she began to see him throwing tantrums, and she began to see him being sly and doing all the things that we do and manifesting his sin nature. I'm sure she was sadly disappointed. And we can see that in the fact that when she had in verse 2, she bore this time and she called his brother Abel, which literally means breath or vanity. It's meaningless. You know, these children are wicked, and that's what she came to understand. And so she calls him Abel. And then it says, "Now Abel was a keeper of the sheep, but Cain was a tiller of the ground." Both fine professions, great profession. Neither one had a terrible profession. "And in the process of time, it came to pass that Cain brought an offering of the fruit of the ground to the Lord." They brought it to the Lord, probably as we understand it. He brought it before the gate. Adam and Eve had probably worshipped before the gate and could see the angel standing there in the gate. And they dare not go into the garden, but they probably built an altar there and worshipped. And they had, mom and dad, Adam and Eve, had taught the boys to worship. And both of them brought the offering of the fruit. And it says, "Abel also brought of the firstborn of the flock of the fat. And the Lord had respect for Abel and his offering, but he did not respect Cain and his offering. And Cain was very angry, and his countenance fell." So the Lord God said to Cain, "Why are you angry? And why has your countenance fallen? If you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do not do well, sin lies at the door, and its desire is for you, but you shall rule over it." So these two come before an altar to worship the Lord God as mom and dad had taught them. Now, I want you to notice several things about this. Both of them knew the Lord as far as his existence. Even though they had not seen God and had not walked in the presence of God as mom and dad, they believed the testimony that there was a God. They knew he needed to be respected. He needed to be worshiped. And they were glad to come. They knew they had to offer offerings to appease God. Now, again, probably taught like Adam and Eve that were taught by God. And so they were very conscientious, religious. We don't know of anything morally that they was wrong with them. They were upright by appearance, sincere, and desiring God's blessing. But one comes with an impure heart and one comes with a true heart. And God warns Cain that you need to approach me in the right way. If you do well, I'll receive you. So Abel offered up a lamb, doubtless a spotless, perfect lamb. And can you imagine what that must have been like? Here he is raising these sheep. He's got this little old bitty lamb, and it's perfect, and it's all fluffy, and it's just a little innocent lamb that he has brought, and he holds it in his arm. And don't you know that little lamb looks to its master and feels secure and rejoices in the touch of its master. And then to see that master take that lamb and have to slit its throat and to drain its blood and to offer its blood. Oh, how horrendous a picture that must have made. In fact, some speculate that when Cain would have saw that, Cain would have said, "What is this? This is a bloody religion." Yeah, been offended, appalled by someone who would think that that would be pleasing to God. And here, Abel offers up a sacrifice to God. And that would have seemed like it was barbaric. It would have seemed like it was heartless. But where did he learn that from? He learned that from God, that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. In fact, in the 11th chapter of Hebrews, it says this in verse 4, "By faith Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous." So Cain had a false religion. He brought his own fruit of his own labors, what he had worked for, what he had done, and Abel just simply by faith offered up a lamb, recognizing that the only way we can find forgiveness of sin, the only way we can approach God and be forgiven for our sins is through blood. Without the shedding of blood, there's no remission of sin. And so he offered up a more righteous, a more acceptable sacrifice. Now, folks, the only way we can approach Jesus is not by our works, not by our goodness or moral reformation. It is by the blood of Jesus Christ. That's all that we need to have, and it is all that God has required of us, is that we come by the blood of Jesus Christ, his Lamb sacrificed for us. As we go forth today, go forth and do good works, but don't do that so that you might be saved. Do that because you've received the Spirit of God and have already been saved. Let us pray together. Father, as we go forth from this day, help us to walk in the cleansing of the blood of Christ, that we might be upright and righteous, that we might be established before you in faith, but also help us to go forth to do the good works that was preordained, that we might walk in them. And we'll give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen.